Okay, morning. Morning, year 10. I can't see you, and I'm not sure if you can see me, but I'll just assume that you can. This morning, for our WOW talk, we have Anisha, who is joining us from Manchester. She left in 2009. She went to study at Queen Mary and then has had a fantastic career working in fintech at some big companies, Amazon, Revlon, and is currently at Klarna. So I'm going to pass straight over to Anisha. Just please, as ever, put any questions that you have in the chat, or tutors can email me them. But please have some questions to finish when Anisha has finished her presentation. Okay, over to you, Anisha.
Fab, thank you. Good morning, everyone. Hope you can all hear me. So yes, as has been alluded to, I left in 2009. 10 points for anyone who can guess where this picture was taken up in the top left-hand corner. I don't have many slides for you today, so I'm just going to whip you through a quick overview of my education background and then my career. So predominantly in tech, buying, e-commerce, and fintech, and then I'll leave some time for questions at the end. What I want to caveat this with is this is very much what I would describe as an irregular career path. I didn't leave school knowing exactly what I wanted to do. I still probably wouldn't answer that question with one answer. There's lots of different areas that I've moved into. And kind of just highlighting that variety in your CV and also in your career is really important, or at least it was for myself. So if I skip through to education, hopefully everyone can see this slide. But I obviously started at Bolton School before I went to university. I was there from juniors through to sixth form. And one of the key things, I wasn't a perfect straight A student the whole time. I was a good student. I put my head down, but I really sought a lot of excitement and enjoyment out of the extracurricular things. So not just the things within school. I was part of the netball team, lacrosse team, did a lot of things within school. We've got such great facilities, but I also did a lot of volunteering and working outside of that. So when I was 16, I got a job at the Bolton School Arts Centre in the waitressing team, and I did that through till I left school. I volunteered at Bolton Lads and Girls Club. I did some work experience at the Bolton School Nursery as well. And I also volunteered and did an internship for a local MP, Brian Iden at the time. And that all that experience that I had outside of school actually led to some great success when I applied for university. So my personal statement stood out because I had done so much other work and developed these soft skills that are really relevant in the world of work. So I was very lucky to go to Queen Mary University of London and do English language and linguistics. That was a subject I really enjoyed at school. And as I say, I didn't know what I wanted to do, so I thought it would cover lots of bases, which it definitely did. After school, sorry, after university, I again wasn't 100% sure where to go next. So I did an internship with Minority Rights Group International. They are based in London. And this was because I was really interested in human rights, the NGO sector, not for profit, but I didn't really have any experience in that area. I really wanted to understand a little bit more about what went on. So I did that for a few months and then had a complete shift and decided to move to Spain, as you do. I did study Spanish at school and really enjoyed it. It was one of my strongest subjects, and I still speak Spanish today, having moved there, and I use it for work as well. The British Council had a great opportunity for young grads at the time to move out to different countries in Europe. So whilst I didn't study languages for my degree, it was an opportunity to do essentially a year abroad, but you were paid to work out in the country. So I lived in Spain for about a year in Madrid, absolutely loved it. Met lots of people, met more people in the not-for-profit organizations as well, just through the British Council, and decided in that time that I would really like to go back to university and do a bit more in that area. So I chose the degree of international relations as a master's with a focus on the human rights law, humanitarian intervention, really just to learn a little bit more about that. And I was very pleased to have been given a scholarship to the Cardiff University Master's Programme, one of the better programmes in the country. So that was great. And incidentally, my mum also did her master's at Cardiff, but it was 36 years prior. So we both get the alumni magazine now. The master's degree was great. It taught me so much about the topic that I knew very little about. And I was really interested, and it, you know, really got my thirst for learning back again. During that time, I also worked. I was working at Lush Cosmetics to fund my way through university, and that was great. Really enjoyed that work experience. After I left Cardiff, it became increasingly clearer to me that it would be interning for a long time in order for me to get to one of the kind of key human rights organizations. And whilst I was really interested in doing it, I thought I could do that alongside doing another career. One of the roles that came up for me was around languages. So Amazon, I'm sure you're all familiar with Amazon. They work globally, and there was an opportunity to join their risk management team. And they were looking for folks who were trilingual and higher. So I also speak a few other languages. French and Spanish were the ones that I used in this role. And predominantly, it was a fraud prevention role. And I did that role for about a year. And I'm not ashamed to admit that I did not enjoy that role at all. It really became clear to me that this wasn't for me, sitting behind the computer and sort of very internal focused. I wanted to be out talking to people. And so I explored my options internally, and I was, you know, really lucky to have some great mentors at Amazon at the time. It's a huge company, very diverse set of people, lots of different avenues you can go down as well. And I chose to go into essentially their version of buying. So this was vendor management. And I got this role from an internal promotion internally. And yeah, really absolutely loved working in the buying arena. Worked in sports, so working with some of the big names like Nike and Adidas, through to some smaller niche yoga brands, and really enjoyed it. So I was at Amazon in total for about 3 years. I then decided I wanted to go on the other side of the coin and actually do the selling side rather than buying. And that's when I was approached by Hasbro. So Hasbro is the second biggest toy company in the world, after Lego, and they own licenses for brands such as Marvel. They also have My Little Pony, Play-Doh. There's a whole array of brands that they have, and I have to say it was one of the most fun jobs I had. Definitely got to play with the toys, which was always fun, and I was an e-commerce manager there, so essentially selling our products to retailers, digital retailers predominantly. Had a blast there. And then one area that I'd always been interested in was beauty. Something I was interested in at school, whether my parents agreed with that or not is a different story, but really wanted to understand under the hood of what actually happens in a beauty company, how do products come to be, that sort of thing. So I was offered a role at Charlotte Tilbury back when they were actually quite a relatively new business as the national account manager. And that was selling both to digital stores, but also to in-store as well. So bricks and mortar. I really found bricks and mortar quite challenging because it's a lot slower than online, but really enjoyed that time. And then that led me on to Revlon. So Revlon is, again, one of the biggest cosmetics companies in the world. They own a number of other brands as well. I started as a senior business development manager and then was promoted to their regional head of e-commerce, looking after Europe. Again, selling on the predominant digital channels. Very much a slower pace than the tech I was used to. And that is what sparked me into Klarna. So Klarna is a Swedish financial tech company. I actually moved from London. I was in London this whole time up until Revlon. And then I moved back to Manchester about 2 years ago, part of the pandemic. And Klarna do have an office in Manchester. And that is how I became a commercial manager there. I've now been there 3 years. And over those years, I've been very lucky to have new opportunities. I am currently the head of partner success. And that is a very fast-paced environment. And because I was missing that so much from my time at Revlon, I really, really enjoy the quite stressful but high-pressured environment that we're in. And we are a relatively new company. We've been around for 15 years. Hopefully you're familiar with us. We are a buy now, pay later a product, first and foremost, but we're also a registered bank in Europe as well. So learning a little bit more about the banking industry has been really fascinating. No plans for me to move from Klarna at the moment, but really enjoying it thus far. And then I just wanted to share some of the things that I've learned along the way. As I said already, don't underestimate the value that volunteering, internships and work experience can bring you when you're at school. But also beyond that, developing soft skills is one of the number one things I look at when I'm hiring in my team. It's really important to have a well-rounded individual rather than somebody who potentially has just been educated and got A's in their exams. It's great to have people doing effective communication, listening actively, being able to express ideas clearly. That's really important. Also, you don't always have to have a plan about what you want to do. I think that can be quite a big pressure when you're at school. You can figure it out as you go. And actually, it's no longer the case that people have been in their roles for 15, 20 years almost. You can change. You can see I've chopped and changed quite a lot. And it's always served me really well. And I've got very varied experience from it. It's a privilege to learn from those around you, whatever level or role you have. Really benefit from that, really soak in the knowledge that you learn from those around you. Really important. Never stop learning. That doesn't mean you have to go back to uni or school. Just whatever it is you're doing, try and push yourself. Embracing a growth mindset is really, really important. And then finally, networking and seeking advice. So building a strong network of mentors, in your case, teachers, other professionals in your desired field, will really set you up for success in the future. And you've got an area you can go to seek guidance as well. And that was it for me.
That's great. Thank you very much, Anisha. We've just got a little bit of time for a few questions, if people could put in some questions in the chat. I do have a question to get started. As you said, you have sort of chopped and changed, as you put it, different careers. What is the actual longest time you've been in one role?
Probably about 3 years. Yeah.
Right.
So, well, probably Klarna now, we're into our fourth year. But I think the misconception, particularly in tech, it's very common. You don't have people, you know, things change so rapidly within the tech space. We don't have people who've been in the company for longer than 3 years, to be honest. I think when we talk about Amazon, they always call it Amazon time because it's much longer than you think. It feels longer than it actually is. And I think people in the past have been scared to do that, to chop and change. But actually, it just adds a lot more diversity to your skill set and shows that you're used to that very fast-paced, ever-changing environment as well. It's not going to be for every category or every vertical, but definitely tech, it's a lot more common.
Okay, thanks. We've got one question. What would you say is your favourite job so far?
Oh, that is a tough one. I'm going to say Klarna, not just because I'm still there, because it's very different to the other roles that I've had. It's not buying or selling product, which is, I mean, I am selling a product, arguably, but it's not a physical product. It's not specific to one category like beauty or sports. I get to work across a number of different categories, which means I can really diversify my skill set. Work with lots of different clients. I currently, my team and I manage the ASOS account, which is a wild animal of an account. So that's really exciting. But at the same time, I get to also work with, you know, Deliveroo, which is a completely different category. So I'd say at the moment, Klarna.
Right, great. Thank you. A question that the students always seem to ask is, what are the benefits? As in, you know, what are the perks? So obviously you've worked for some big companies, haven't you, like Amazon, etc. What would you say are the main perks of working for those? Do you get discounts? Do you get things like, what is the additional that you get?
Sure. I would say perks change the older you get as well. I think when I was younger, I was really into like Charlotte Tilbury. I have a Charlotte Tilbury store upstairs because I've got so much product left over from my time. And that is great. And freebies are great. But then as you sort of get more settled into your role, it's things like flexible working is really important. As I said, I live in Manchester, but my team is London-based, so I get to go there every other week, and I've got a company that covers that. That's great. I would also say just my exposure and networking is so wide from having these roles. You know, these are big names. People want to talk to these names. So having people I can call up and say, you know, I'd love an invite to the British Fashion Awards. Can you give sort that out for me? You know, those kinds of things are the perks that I think are also beneficial.
Yeah, that they connection.
Yeah.
Did you find it challenging relocating to Manchester? Did you, maybe, is it a bit slower pace? wanted to come back to Manchester, or was that just because of the job?
I actually wanted to. I was in London in total about 12 years. And don't get me wrong, London is fantastic. It's a great place to be, particularly during your 20s. But I was ready to buy a house. We now have a little dog, which we never would have had before. And Manchester just allowed us to do that. But I would say initially I was very sad to leave London, obviously friends, but I would
Yeah.
say that adjusting to the pace of life and everything that you have available in Manchester was a great privilege. I'm so happy that I'm back as well.
Right, great. Just a couple of quick questions because we are running out a little time. What A level subjects did you take?
I did Spanish, English language, and history.
Right. And so that Spanish really did come in for
It's
your first job, didn't it?
very much so. I did do
Yeah.
French GCSE, which stuck with me, and I speak seven languages in total. So
Wow.
they
Okay.
do all come in handy at different occasions. So languages was my favorite subject, I would say.
Right. I think this might have to be our last question, but what would you say? What's your normal week? Do you go into the office? Do you work from home? What sort of day? Do you go to London? What would be a
Yeah,
normal
so
week?
I split my time between Manchester and London. I work from home. I'm at home right now.
Right.
But I go to London every other week for 2 to 3 days. It's something
Right.
that the company covers. If it wasn't that case, I'm very lucky I don't have to go into the office. We've got a fully 100% flexible working policy. So I tend to
Right.
work from home if I'm not in London.
And what would you be doing? So would you be having meetings, writing reports?
Yeah, back-to-back meetings. I manage a
Right.
team of 8 people, so meetings with them, meetings with their clients, meetings
Right.
with our CXOs, lots of meetings, but then I
Lots of
keep
meetings.
Fridays free for the work, to crack on with the work.
Right. That's super. Thanks very much for joining us this morning,
No
Anisha. And
problem.
thank you, students, for all the questions that you've given me this morning. Sorry, I didn't get to the last question.
Feel free to email them over to me and I'm happy to come back to you.
All right, thank you. It was about how you financed yourself between jobs, but I assume that you actually just didn't move from one job to the next until you just secured it.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
I didn't have any gaps.
Yes.
I
Yeah. So you don't tend to leave gaps, do you, in jobs when you
don't.
don't need to?
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, well, what a fantastic, exciting career you've had.
Yeah,
And many
brilliant.
thanks, Anisha.
No
Really,
problem.
really
Thanks so
great
much,
to hear that.
everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Thank you so much,
Thanks.
Anisha.
No worries. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Thanks, Anisha. Have a great day.
That was
Thanks very
brilliant.
much.
Oh,
All
wrapping the
right.
video
You
up.
take
Thank
care.
you so much, and good luck
No
with the
problem.
baby. Don't forget to
Oh,
send
thank
us a
you.
picture for the
Oh,
old girls'
no.
newsletter.
Oh,
Oh,
yes.
when are
We've got time
you due?
yet. April.
Oh,
Oh,
well,
yeah.
congratulations. Hope
Thank you.
everything
All
goes well.
very soon. But
We'll look
very
forward
soon.
to that. Yeah.
Yeah,
Yes, I'll
take care.
drop you a note. Take care. Thanks so
Take
much.
care,
Okay,
Anisha.
thanks very
Bye-bye.
much. Bye.